we are still vulnerable as a country because with a small hinterland, land mass is quite fixed. We're not growing in size. There's still the traditional fault lines between racial groups, between religions. And we have new ones also. You know, for example, if you have look at the discussions about income divide, I think that's some invisible divisions there within the society. There's also this divide between foreign and local. That's also can be a hot issue, and sometimes tense moments can arise out of that fault lines. And there's also this divide with values between the conservative and the liberal. So Madonna is probably one of the more recent examples. Plus interest groups has divides too. So recent example again could be the cross-island line that we talked about, how nature lovers can sometimes be, you know, mobilizing themselves for the reasons that they think are valid against certain national development objectives, or even different interests of landowners, for example, that has to be affected by decisions on the MRT tunnel. So another one is actually along the age, yeah, because increasingly we are aging. So in some societies, we have seen how the younger people feel that the elderly, it's in a way getting more resources than they do. So for example, in systems where there's a very significant pension element in their government spending, and a large part of government budget goes into paying the elderly, then you have voices about, what about us from the younger segment of the society?